Of course, everyone, even. With the clickers, everyone answered, and without the clickers, almost all of you answered that you notice a pressure change. Why is that pressure changing? What is this steady state model about? Well, what this delta means is if you pick two points in the fluid, delta is the difference between the energy density, whichever one you're talking about. I wrote down pressure, but whichever energy density you're talking about, the difference between the energy density at that point and some other point. If you swim 3 meters down in a pool, then your gravitational potential energy has gone down. What about these other things? Has the kinetic energy of the water in the pool changed? Is the water in the pool, first of all, is the water in the pool at the top of the pool moving at all? Not in most pools. Maybe in a lake, maybe in a stream, you might have kinetic energy. But in a swimming pool, the water is not moving, and so it's just a static situation. There's no kinetic energy at all. Either at the top of the pool or 3 meters down, no kinetic energy because nothing's moving. The water's just sitting there. It's not a flow problem. So the kinetic energy isn't changing. That second term isn't changing. Is there a pump in between the top of the pool and the bottom of the pool? No. So you can throw the pump issue away. There's nothing putting in energy between those two points. Current is when something's flowing. So the current, is equal to zero for the swimming pool because nothing's flowing. So you end up with a bunch of zeros and a pressure change that comes out because there's a change in height, a change in gravitational potential energy. The pressure change is equal and opposite to the change in gravitational potential energy. Gravitational potential energy, when you go 3 meters down, goes down. Pressure, up. One goes down, one goes up. This is how you can calculate the pressure difference. Why did I have to say 3,000 meters for dropping through the air? What's different between the air and the water that's up here, that's on that equation? Is G different? Yeah, what? Yeah, rho is different. How much different? You did this in 7A. How different is a gas at standard temperature and pressure versus a liquid? What's the difference in the density, roughly? What factor? How much? I know that in 7A you took liquid nitrogen, put it into a gas, into a bag, inflated the bag, and measured the volume, and you found out it was how much bigger? The atoms were 10 times farther apart in each of three directions. It was like 600 to 900 times bigger volume. Maybe even 1,000. I'm going to pretend it's 1,000 because that rounds it right off. If they're 10 times farther apart in each direction, then the volume got 10 times 10 times 10 bigger. So you do remember, that's good. If the volume is 1,000 times bigger, then the density is 1,000 times smaller. So you have to drop 1,000 times more in the air to change the gravitational potential energy density by the same amount as if you went in water. Which is why I don't feel my ears popping when I walk up and down these stairs. Now I have a question about kinetic energy. So I want you to tell me how you decide, by answering this question, how you decide about kinetic energy changes. So, here's a pipe. Remember, every pipe I showed you is filled with liquid. Even if I don't show it all, it's filled with liquid. I'm going to only show some of the liquid in the pipe. So here's t equals 0 seconds. Here's t equals 1 second. I showed you the same liquid at two different times. The red section highlights two separate volumes of that flowing water. This is 1 liter of water. When it gets into that smaller cross-sectional area pipe, that's the 1 liter of water. That's where it is right now. Because it gets into the, when it gets into that smaller pipe, it gets spread out because the cross-sectional area is not as big. And it's an incompressible fluid, so its volume has to stay the same. The water highlighted on the left side has moved to this from here to here in 1 second. You can see that it's moved a distance equal to its width. This one, well, it has to move a distance equal to its width. In other words, the water behind it completely pushes it to the new step. Whatever water was behind here pushed this over to here, right next door to the first one. This one got pushed over to here, right next door to the first one. This tells us that, A, the later time t on the right side, so I'm asking you what this time here is. Later time t on the right side is 4 or 5 seconds, because it moved 4 or 5 times as far. Or the liter of water highlighted on the right side is moving 4 or 5 times faster. Or both of the above, or none of the above, or who knows?